Hey everyone, it's FCA and welcome to FCA Friday. First up, I want to apologize if I'm eating a lot and getting a drink. I'm not feeling 100%. I have a notebook with notes, so if I'm looking down, apologies in advance. This video is all about planning a bridal shower, which is something I've had to do for my friend. The bridal shower is the bride herself is a very conservative and traditional kind of person. And so that's going to go with that theme. And I'm showing these tips and advice will typically be applied to just about any event that you're going to have, whether it be another bridal shower or a birthday party. These are things to consider and take in mind, with of course tweaking, which I'm sure will be self-explanatory. So the bridal shower, if you're not sure what it is because you live in the UK or something like that, a bridal shower is an event. Is a pre-wedding event for the bride to give her gifts and for the female members to give her advice about marital life and marriage. And this is also traditionally one of the last times that the bride to be will see her family because, you know, typically when the bride gets married, she's away with him. But all females who are invited to the wedding are traditionally invited to the bridal shower. And it used to be exclusively females. If you've heard of a wedding shower is more like a pre-wedding ceremony reception. The reception is after the ceremony, and the wedding shower is before, and everybody just gets invited to that. But bridal showers are a little bit more traditional, and people have, over the years, been willing to add, you know, brothers, and people like that to their bridal showers. There is going to be a male because there is a man of honor instead of the maid of honor. Speaking of which, it is the bridal party who mostly pays for the event. There are a lot of costs to consider, both in time and money, and those rest on, as I said, the bridal party, the bridesmaid and maid or mistress, man of honor. And most of the brunt of that is on the maid of honor, most of the time. In this case, because there's a little bit of a location difference, there's a little bit of an unusual circumstance, that's falling on me, just one of the regular bridesmaids, which is fine with me. And I did it willingly, I wasn't forcing to do anything. But when you have a bridal shower, you want to plan roughly about a month to a month and a half before the wedding. So the wedding that I'm going to be in is June 4th. I'm having the bridal shower at the end of April 24th, 2016. Right now it's about 2 weeks before that. And you want to have time to get invitations out so people can take time off work, give people a chance to RSVP to you. That way you still have time, whether you're just going off of who you're inviting or if you're going off of strictly the RSVP. You can decide, you know, how many favors to get, where to have the venue, how much food to order, all of that. Usually a lunch brunch kind of event. So it's usually anywhere after 10 a.m. and before 5 p.m. So somewhere in that afternoon kind of area, before dinner, after breakfast. But I have notes, so which is also why there's a tea party too for a lot of bridal showers, which is cute, but not with the nice. When you're making invitations, always expect, this is just a general thing again, just expect that half of the people get adding 5 to 15, depending on how large the group is, will be attending the actual event. Sometimes people suddenly have to work, or sometimes people who didn't need had to work don't. Sometimes people bring children unexpectedly, so you have extra guests you didn't plan for, or maybe did. And, or sometimes it's a last minute, oh, I forgot to invite, you know, some coworker that you're close to. And you want to have that time, as I said, for how long to make your bridal shower, it's really going to depend on A, the size of the amount of people who are coming, because you want to make sure you have time to get most of them in at the beginning, and you also want to make sure that you're going to have time for everybody to eat. So if you're having a main lunch meal, if you're having a big lunch, whether it be catered or buffet style, you want to make sure everybody has time to get their food and eat without feeling rushed. Or if they're having finger food, you still want to make sure they have time to get to enjoy it and take pictures, mingle. And the amount of gifts that you have is usually going to reflect the amount of gifts that the bride has to open. And there's also going to be time to do a couple games, depending. You also want to include time. So this goes into renting your venue. You want to make sure that you include time for taking down and setting up an event. Setting up an event can take, I would think you would want to give yourself at least 40 minutes. So half an hour to an hour, depending on how big it is, how elaborate you're making it. And you want to make sure that your venue, when you're renting it out, that they allow you time to take it down. Takedown is usually about half the amount of time a setup is. And that's just because there's less food, because it will be eaten, the favors and things have been taken away. You don't have to be as careful with anything, because you can just, you know, shove all the fake flowers and petals and stuff like that. You can just shove them into a box. You don't have to smooth them out all pretty light. Speaking of venues, you want to make sure that you have a venue that will, of course, hold all of your guests. You want to make sure that it's a place, there are things that you're going to want to ask a venue. Do they already have chairs and tables, or is that something you're going to have to rent on your own? If you're having in somebody's backyard, you're going to have to find chairs and tables you may have to rent, or gazebos. You want to know if your venue is going to allow helium balloons, if they're going to allow real candles, if they're going to allow alcohol. How strict are they on their time limits? Those are all things that you're going to want to ask. And also, can you use thumbtacks or nails to hold up decorations, or how does that work? And that way you make sure, you have a backup plan. They say it's in the middle of summer, if it rains or storms unexpectedly, are you going to have time or a place to be able to move things indoors? This all that stuff goes into cost to consider. I mentioned who takes on the cost, but what are those costs exactly? There's the venue itself. Again, are you renting gazebos for somebody's backyard, or are you going to, say, a community center or a church basement? You're going to have costs for invitations, stamps. There's going to be, you have banners, food and drink, ice. You're going to need something to hold up the decorations. So, as I said, thumbtacks or tape or sticky tack, balloons, just batteries, lighters, the candles themselves, the candy dishes for if you're having a dessert table. If you're going to have cellophane or ribbon, you're going to have the thank you cards and the envelopes, vases, fairy lights, chair and table rentals. Tableware, so napkins, tablecloths, eatery, all that stuff. And there's just a lot of those little things that end up coming up, like napkins, that you have to include in your cost considerations. And of course, there's stuff like prizes for the games. Are you going to have to get special things for the games? Are you going to have the food catered? Is it going to be a full meal, a finger food? Are you going to have a candy buffet? Is there going to be wine and alcohol present? Are you having it at a bar-like setting? So is that an open bar? Is it seated? How are you doing that? Are you going to be one of those cute things where you have a cocktail table set up and everyone can make their own cocktail because you have a cocktail mix or recipe set up? I suggest that no matter what drinks you're having, always have chilled bottled water of some kind or a carafe of water, just because anybody can drink water. I know zero people who are allergic to bottled water. And you never know when you're going to have to clean up a spill, and you anything but a water bottle on hand, or whatever else. Or coffee. A lot of people like coffee. I don't like coffee myself. And no matter what kind of food you're having, I always recommend also having some sort of meat, whether it's sandwich meat, unless you're all vegetarians and vegans. You know, I would recommend having, you know, some sort of meat substance. Usually a salad. One, they look really decorative and pretty. Two, they're healthy. And three, they're a nice filler item. And of course, dessert, you would want either to have cake or cupcakes, or maybe a little cake with a bunch of cupcakes, which is what I'm doing. And cookies, if you're going to have a little candy buffet or anything like that. There's loads of favors. People, you always want to give your guests when it comes to weddings or bridal showers or bachelorette parties. I always think that it's good to give somebody a little takeaway kind of goodie bag or goodie item. You can do cellophane bags so people can take candy and cookies home with them. Which, by the way, additional cost, make sure you have either saran wrap or foil so people can take food home so you're not eating it all and not be able to fit into your bridesmaid's dress. You can do things like this. This is a little lip gloss, and I have the, it's personalized with a sticker. It says Rachel's Bridal Shower with date. You can do these little bags, these drawstring bags, which people can put candies in. These are actually going to be on table settings with candies in them. And they have cellophane bags. Or there's things like this, the traditional candy mint tin, which has that matching personalization on it. And the little mints I got have like wedding bells and hearts on them. And I got all my favorites from nicefavors.com. But you would also, I recommend check out Party City. They tend to have the same things for similar prices that might be more convenient for you. I also have, for the table settings, I have these little rings around the napkin. I thought that just looked so cute, and I just found it on Google Images. I didn't come up with that on my own. There's like chocolate lace lollipops that you can do. One thing that I do recommend that you do, which I'm having my bride do, is we're doing, here are the thank you cards I ordered. The colors, if you haven't noticed, are dark blue and white. And bring the envelope and have the guests fill out their own envelopes at the tables or whatever, or have a little podium set aside for it. That way that saves the bride time and money later. Not so much money, I guess, in the suit. And you want to make sure you have somebody to write down what everybody got for the bride, so that she knows who to thank for what. And when you're picking games, keep them simple and keep it 2 to 3 games depending on the size of your party. The 2 games that I'm doing at my bridal shower is Do You Know the Bride and Groom? And I just have 15 questions, like what color are the groom's eyes? What are the groom's parenting? What did the bride graduate with? What was her major in college? What's the bride's favorite animal? What's the groom's favorite food? Just questions like that. And we're going to go down. I'm going to print it off, have it at the table as the game. And whoever gets the most right, there's going to be prizes for those people. Let's see. When it comes to decorating, you want to either just stick with the theme or just stick with the wedding colors. Keep it simple. And when it comes to decorations, I also have it simple. I'm going to be doing the floating the pearls with a simple vase. And this little packet comes with a little thing. I have some of these pom-poms that I made myself. They're the kitchen pom-poms. I also have some origami butterflies, the bride's favorite thing is butterflies, and I'm going to be adding these on, not these specific ones, but I have ones to put on the cupcakes. There's going to be some sage roses, and for the hair, there's going to be these clover leaf tissue paper garlands that are really inexpensive. So I hope that you I'll try and remember to find all of them to link them below, and I'll talk to you later.